Happy day, children. Okay, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. Okay, today, children, we will start with new poem. That is our visit to the zoo. Did you get the new poem? Is our visit to the zoo. Okay, now, what do you mean by zoo, children? What do you mean by zoo? Zoo is a collection of animals. Sorry, a collection of wild animals where they are cared. Zoo is a place where different kinds of wild animals are kept and they are taken care by the people and visitors can visit them. Okay. Every time we can't go for jungles, we can't go for other places to see animals. So, in the zoo we can find different kinds of animals in the same place. Right. Now, this poem is also about zoo. Okay, and before that, our Bannerghatta is also famous for zoo, right? Yes, our village also is very famous for zoo. And what are the things we have? We have different kinds of animals. We have lion and tiger safari and butterfly park. Okay, these are the three things we have. And in the zoo, what are the animals we can find? We can find tiger, foxes, then peacock, white peacock, then parrot and different kinds of parrots, tarcoon, snakes, crocodiles, turtles and many other wild animals. Right. To see these animals, we can't go for jungle. Right, children? So, zoo is a place where we can see the animals. Right. I hope even you have visited the zoo, a national park, and you have enjoyed a lot. Right. Now, this is also about a zoo and here the poet tells what are the things he sees when he visits zoo. Okay, children, let's start our poem. Now, when we went to the zoo, we saw new When we went to the zoo, we saw a gnu, an elk and a whelk and a wild emu. The daughter is telling, when we went to the zoo, we saw a gnu, an elk and a whelk and a wild emu. We saw a hare and a bear in his lair. We saw a hare and a bear in his lair and a seal have a meal on a high-backed chair. A seal have a meal on a high back chair. We saw a snake that was hardly awake. We saw a snake that was hardly awake and a lion eat meat that they hadn't forgotten to bake. And a lion eat meat they had forgotten to bake. We saw a coon and a baby baboon. We saw a coon and a baby baboon. The giraffe made us laugh all afternoon. The giraffe made us laugh all afternoon. We saw a crab and a long-tailed dab. We saw a crab and a long-tailed dab. And we all went home in a taxi cab. And we all went home in a taxi cab. Here in this poem, the author, who is the author of this or the poet of this poem? Jesse Pope. Jesse Pope is the poet of the poem Our Visit to the Zoo. Here our poet explains that her experience. The poet explains her experience when she visits the zoo. What are the animals she finds in the zoo? Okay, now I'll explain one more time. We'll read the poem one more time and explain. I'll read out the poem and explain you. Okay, when we went to the zoo, we saw a gnu. Here the poet is telling that when she went to the zoo, She saw a nu. Here the word is nu. Here G is silent. Okay. It's not nu. We have to leave this G. We should not spell this G and we should say only nu. Here nu means a wild animal, wild beast. Okay, nu means wild beast. When we went to the zoo, we saw a nu, an elk and a whelk, and a wild emu. An elk and a whelk and a wild emu. Here elk means a large deer. Elk means a large deer. Elk means large deer. Whelk. Well, a small shellfish. When you go to beach, you'll find a shell, seashell. That shellfish is known as whelk. Okay. Now, and a wild emu. Emu is an Australian bird. Now, here the author is telling, when we went to the zoo, we saw a nu, an elk and a whelk and a wild emu. Here she says that when she visits zoo, she'll see an elk and whelk and an emu. We saw a hare and a bear in his lair. We saw a hare and a bear in his lair. He is telling that we saw a hare. Hare means here hard. Okay. We saw a hare and a bear in his lair. They saw hare and a bear which was in the lair. Here lair means a place. Lair. Okay, lair. Lair means a place where wild animals live, like den. Okay, lair means den. Lair, a place where wild animals live. When this went after seeing elk, whelk and emu, they'll move to the next. Okay, now where what they'll see there? They'll see a horse and bear which was living, which was resting in the lair. And a seal have a meal on a high back chair. And a seal have a meal on a high back chair. They also see seal. Seal means a kind of a sea. Seal. Here seal means a sea animal. Seal means a sea animal. Here in the book you can see this is seal, right? And the seal have a meal on a high back chair. And they will also see that a seal, a sea animal, will be having its meal. We saw a snake that was hardly awake. We saw a snake that was hardly awake. They'll see a snake which was sleeping. And a lion eat meat that forgotten to bake. And the lion eat meat that they had forgotten to bake. Here the author is telling that they also saw that lion eating the meat which was not baked. Baked means cooked. Bake. Cook. The author is telling lion was eating its meal which was not cooked. We saw a coon and a baby baboon. We saw a coon and a baby baboon. Here coon means a kind of animal. See here in your picture, in the poem, last animal, coon here. This animal is called as coon, that is raccoon. Okay, the animal name is raccoon here. They have given in a short form. And a baby baboon. Baboon means a monkey. Okay, we saw a coon and a baby baboon. The giraffe made us laugh all afternoon. The author is telling, after seeing the lion and the hare and the snake, they will move to the next section where they will see raccoon and baboon and also see that the tiger was enjoying and it making the visitors to laugh. Okay, by its or actions, right? They here the author is telling that by seeing the giraffe's action, we enjoyed a lot, and giraffe made us laugh all afternoon. In the afternoon, we saw a crab, a long tail dab. We saw a crab and a long tail dab. Here, dab means a small fish. A small fish with flat body. Flat body. A small fish with flat body. And we all went home in a taxi cab. And we all went home in a taxi cab. Last, what they'll see? They'll see crab and a long-tailed dab. After visiting all the sections, last they'll come to the crab and they also see long-tailed dab. And after that, they will go back to their home in a taxi. Understood? Now, again I'll read out poem for you. When we went to the zoo, we saw a gnu, an elk and a whelk and a white emu. We saw a hare and a bear in his lair. We saw a hare and a bear in his lair. And a seal have a meal on a high backed chair. And a seal have a meal on a high backed chair. We saw a snake that was hardly awake. We saw a snake that was hardly awake. And a lion eat meat they had forgotten to bake. And a lion eat meat they had forgotten to bake. We saw a coon and a baby baboon. We saw a coon and a baby baboon. The giraffe made us laugh all afternoon. The giraffe made us laugh all afternoon. We saw a crab and a long-tailed dab. We saw a crab and a long-tailed dab. And we all went home in a taxi cab. And we all went home in a taxi cab. Understood, children? Okay, this poem is about the author visiting the zoo and what are the things she'll experience and what are the animals she see there. She'll explain in a way of poetry. Okay, and this poem is written by Jessie Pope. She's the author name is Jessie Pope. Here she explains that what are the animals she'll see when she visits the zoo. She says that when we visited zoo, we saw they will see gnu, elk, whelk, okay, and a wild emu. First they'll see elk. Elk means a large deer, and whelk a shellfish, and an emu. Okay, and after that, what they'll see? They will see a hare and a bear. The next section they'll see a bear and a hare. Even in our zoo also we have different sections, right? Like for tiger, small part they have given, and for animals and for snakes, for crocodiles, they have made separate division. Same way here also, after seeing one section, the poet is explaining her experiences. Okay, first she'll go and see the gnu and elk and whelk. Okay, after that she'll go to a place where hares were kept. Okay, after that hare, they'll see a bear which was resting in the lair. Okay, and next, a seal have a meal. Here they also see that seal. A seal means here sea animal having its meal. And a high-backed chair. A seal was sitting on a chair and it was having its meal. We saw a snake that was hardly awake. They also see the snake which was resting. Okay. Now, a lion eat meat they had forgotten to bake. When they had visited the zoo, it was the afternoon. So, it was the time for animals to have their food. So, here she is explaining that when she saw a bear also, the bear was resting And when she went to see seal, the seal animal also will be having its meal. And she also sees that lion was also having its meat and which was not cooked. Okay, here he is telling that we should, the wild animals are, will eat the food like raw itself. Okay, they are not cooked. The food or the meat will not be cooked for the wild animals. They will eat raw flesh. We saw a coon and a baby baboon, and after visiting the lion, they'll go into the next section. Okay, which section? They will see a coon. Coon means here raccoon. It is a kind of animal. Okay, raccoon, and also they will see a baby baboon. Baby baboon means a small monkey. The giraffe made us laugh after noon. Here they also see that giraffe with his actions, he is making the visitors to laugh. Now, we saw a crab and a long-tailed dab. We saw a crab and a long-tailed dab. Here, the last section was the section of the small animals. They'll see crab and a dab. Dab means here a small fish with flat body. They'll see crab and the long-tailed flat body fish, and after seeing that they will enjoy lot in the zoo and they will get back to their home. Understood, children? I hope you have understood. And here I have written few words, the animal names. Okay, so no, it is GNU, so we should not pronounce G. Okay, G is silent, and no, we have to pronounce it as nu. Nu, wild beast. Elk, a large deer. Nu, wild beast. Elk, large deer. Elk, large deer. Whelk, shell fish. Whelk, shell fish. Lair, a place where wild animals live. Lair, a place where wild animals live. Next. Seal, a sea animal. Seal, a sea animal. Bake, cook. Dab, a small fish with flat body. Dab, a small fish with flat body. Okay, children, I hope you have understood the poem. In the next class, if you have any doubts, I'll clear your doubts. Okay, children, thank you.